Hallelujah. The interview. Hallelujah. We've been over, a few of them. Amen. Now we're down to the job description. Somebody say job description. Amen. We're going to be coming from Romans chapter 12, starting with verse 1. So get that together. Romans chapter 12, starting with verse 1. Previously, we talked about the interview. Amen. Have the opening statement. Amen. We had, are you a citizen? Have you been found guilty of a crime? Amen. And then last week we talked about your hire. Amen. You have the job. Tell somebody you got the job. Amen. Amen. It's a freely given job. Amen. All you have to do is accept it. Amen. But when you accept this job, you have some responsibility. Amen. It's not just any old job. Amen. It's not a job that you can take lightly, because this job that you have, amen, this job that you have not only affects you, but it affects others around you. Amen. So we all have to do our job together, amen, so that we can function properly. Amen. Amen. We all have to stay in our place. Hallelujah. Amen. We all have to do our jobs to the best of our ability. Amen. Or better yet, amen, if you lean on God, come on somebody, amen, your ability, amen, doesn't really, amen, come into full effect, amen, because it's God that enables us, amen, to do what he has commanded us to do. Let's get into the word, amen, because we're going to do a lot of reading today. Amen. Amen. I love coming from the word of God. Amen. The word of God, I tell you, this scripture here really explains itself. Amen. So we're talking about the job description today. Amen. It says here in the word of God, Romans chapter 12, verse 1, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Amen. When I read this scripture, amen, it talks about sacrificing your body. Amen. I thought it was always talking about laying down your life. Amen. For the word of God, which will also be a reasonable service. But here, amen, it's talking about just making yourself available to be used. That's what sacrifice is. Amen. Making yourself available to be used. Amen. When I think about sacrifice, it takes me back, amen, to Abraham. Amen. And Isaac. Amen. Isaac allowed himself to be used. Amen. We look at Abraham as doing something great. Amen. But it was Isaac that was willing, come on now, to lay down his life. He did not fight. Now, my father tied me up. When I see a sticking over there, he's going to have problems. Come on, y'all too quiet now. I want you to understand, amen, what Isaac went through. Hallelujah. He laid there, amen, and he trusted God. He trusted God. He was no little four-year-old kid. Hallelujah. When he went up to the mountain. Hallelujah. But he heard what his father said. He heard his father say, we will return. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. He heard what his father said and he trusted God. Amen. But I want you to understand that this sacrifice that we're talking about is allowing yourself to be available to be used. It says, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Hallelujah. We're talking about the job description now. Hallelujah. It says, for I say, though the grace given unto me to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God has dealt to us, every man, the measure of faith. For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office. Really? Everybody can't be the pastor. one body. And it takes all of the members of the body to make the body work correctly.
We realize, saints of God, that regardless of what position God has us in, we have to do that to the best of our ability.
Hallelujah. You know, I think about the eyes. When we desire to have something, our eyes will look at that thing. Amen. But if your hands don't work, you cannot take it. Hallelujah. Amen. You might be able to smell something. It might smell really good and tasty, but if you don't have the sense of taste, come on now. How good really is it to you? Hallelujah. What I'm saying today is that wherever you find yourself in the body of Christ, don't discount yourself. There is none big and there is none little in Christ Jesus. We all have a job to do. We help one another. Having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given us, whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith. Our ministries, let us wait. What? Let us wait. Somebody say, wait. Not my opinion. This is the word. Let us wait on our ministry.
So that everything you do, you're doing it to serve the Lord.
It's not for yourself. It's for serving the Lord.
We should not be waiting for someone else to correct us. We should know. Come on now. You know what you're doing.
Come on. You know where you're falling short. Amen. You got to check yourself. We read this morning. Let every man examine himself. Hallelujah. Examine yourself. Amen. It says here, amen, in 1 Corinthians 11 and 28, but let every man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. Amen. Does that mean just communion? We're not just talking about communion, but we're talking about doing the things of God. You got to make sure that you're representing God 24 hours a day. You can't take 8 hours off from being a child of the Most High God. Hallelujah. You got to do it in season and out of season. Hallelujah. When you're tired, when you're energetic, you always have to, amen, be an example for Jesus Christ. There's too many people watching you. Hallelujah. And as I was saying a few weeks ago, you don't want to be a hypocrite. Amen. This is the job description now we're talking about. Amen. You know, we come to the Lord and we say, you know, we say the Lord's Prayer. And we say, I'm saved, I'm saved, I'm saved. And we think that it ends there, but it doesn't. It begins there.
Therefore, if thy enemy hunger, feed him. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
I know we like to just read and glance over this stuff and not apply it to our lives. Amen. Have anybody ever had your enemy come back up on you? After you know they did you wrong, I mean, they might not ask you for, you know, a meal or anything like that, but they ask you for something. You know they did you wrong. Amen. But God, amen, he will come into that situation and enable you to overlook. Y'all know how I always talk about how we can overlook things. That's love that enables us to overlook things.
Hallelujah. Certain ones, amen, you have a problem forgiving sometimes. Amen. But then I realize that a lot of times those people, they forgot what they've done to you. They're not even no longer looking for your forgiveness. So who is that thing really bothering? It's only bothering you. They don't even need your forgiveness anymore. They done moved on.
Job description, it ain't easy, y'all. Hallelujah. It's not easy. But these are the things that are required of us according to the word of God. It says, feed him. If he thirsts, give him drink. For in doing so, thou shalt heap coals of fire.
My father always talking about these scriptures to me.
Shall heap coals of fire on his head. Because I'm going to tell you right now, God will remind him. You don't even have to.
2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 5.
don't have much longer. Talking about the job description today. There was so much in that scripture. Amen. Now we want to talk about examining yourself.
Amen. Hallelujah. I love the scripture.
It says here, examine yourselves whether ye be in the faith. Oh man, I love this. Prove your own self.
All right.
Amen. Let me read that again. Prove your own self. Know ye not your own selves, how that Christ Jesus is in you, except you be the reprobate? Prove your own self. Amen. Everybody's waiting for somebody else to prove them. Prove yourself. Whether you be in the faith. Whether you're standing upright for the faith. Not that you should be acting like you're a child of God, but he's saying be a child of the Most High God. Don't act like you got the job. Don't act like you know what you're doing when you don't. Hallelujah. Don't act like you no longer need to wait on your calling. Hallelujah. I got a kick out of my brother William on last week. Amen. We were talking about being sick. Amen. Brother William, he replied, he said, yeah, some people think they were sick, but they just went. They think they were sick, but they just went. They went ahead of God. They went ahead of their calling, and they find themselves outside of the perfect will of God. Hallelujah. But is it up to me to tell you that? Examine yourself. Amen. It's all about God. It's not about you. It's about God. Hallelujah. Amen. So don't let people have to, you know, I'm trying to make my job a little easier here today. Don't make people come sit you down when you know you're not doing right. Prove yourself. Sit yourself down. We're supposed to have a fear of God. Where is your fear of God? Hallelujah. Amen. I'm not talking about love now. I'm talking about straight up fear. Fearing the wrath of God. Fearing the judgment of God. See, when you're in God's will, you don't have to worry about God's judgment. Hallelujah. People see, oh, judgment day is coming. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Judgment day is coming. Thank you, Jesus. Because when it comes to the children of God, judgment day means reward.
Yes.
Hallelujah. It means somebody shout reward. Hallelujah. I'm going to get my prize. He's going to tell me I came in first place.
Yeah. job.
Yes.
Amen. Because this is understand, a man, that when it comes to this job, amen, this is an inclusive job. He wants you to be a recruiter. How many of us are recruiters today? Amen. Some of us are just satisfied with just having a job, but that ain't it. Part of the job is compelling others to come in. There may be issues in your life, but you got to turn it over to Jesus. I mean, really turn it over, and then you have to turn away. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. A lot of us are turning it over, but we're still holding on to it. We play a tug of war with God. We gotta lay that thing at the altar and then turn away from sin. Instead of turning your back on God, turn your back on the sin.
Amen.
Turn your back on the shame. And don't tell me God can't deliver. Well, Pastor, you just don't understand. Yes, I do.
Amen.
I've been there. I embrace my history. I embrace the things that I used to do that I don't do no more. God wants us to turn it over to Him. Thank you, Jesus. He wants us to have, God, don't you understand? God will not allow you to have an excuse to keep you from doing His will.
Amen.
I believe that with all my heart. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's up to us to do what God has called us to do.
That's right.
Amen. I think about this church. Amen. We are called Citadel of Hope Mission, a place of refuge, a place of hope. Amen. Amen. And I was discussing with our ministers here, amen, that we have to focus on our mission.
Yes.
Let us not lose sight of who we are.
Amen.
Amen. We were named this name for a purpose.
Amen.
Paul is writing this letter, amen, telling them, amen, that he's doing this, amen, not to just beat them up, but for your edification, to help you to grow and become strong in God. Hallelujah. Amen. Your sins and your shortcomings are not pointed out, amen, to make you more weak and to make you feel bad. Hallelujah. It's to make you grow up and face what's in front of you. Finally, my brethren, farewell. Be perfect. Be of good comfort. Be of one mind. Live in peace. And the God of love and the peace shall be with you. Do you believe that together?
We pray that you have been blessed through the Word of God on today, encouraged and strengthened. We extend a warm invitation to you to come into fellowship with us at 70 North Grove Street, East Orange, New Jersey.